So for the next presentation, we have Salvatore here. So Salvatore, the mic is on your computer, please.
Okay, thank you so much. Let me go to the presentation. So the talk of today is about the recent activities and achievements of our harmonious cost action. The aim of the action is try to identify new protocols and guidelines in order to enhance and improve our ability to monitor environmental variables such as stream flow, vegetation, and rivers. The cost action is a growing community that includes right now more than 36 countries and more than 200 scientists. So it's a huge community. The structure of the action and the structure of the working groups that are collaborating within this action is sketched in this slide, and where everyone has a clear perception of the leaders taking responsibility and coordinating each individual activity and focus group. Within the last 2 years, we have obtained a significant number of achievements. A number of deliverables have been obtained. I like to mention those because these are important steps in our work. The first one is a review paper identifying the aims and the scope of the action in the manuscript of 2018. This I have to say, and I'm proud to say that it's one of the top viewed article on remote sensing in the last 2 years. We have built and we are building data set for our application. This is a good example of paper that we built in working group 4, providing a data set for drone application for river monitoring, in this case most specifically for image velocimetry application. In this context, we have built also some experimental application on the use of different algorithms for image velocimetry application, making an intercomparison of them, try to test, try to understand which one works better than others, so which one we can choose in under certain circumstances, and so on. This is, I try to also to report the impact of this of each of this publication, because it's relevant how our cost action is attracting and progressing in the communities is somehow communicating well our discoveries. In our working group, we have one result that has been published in a paper on drones that is also receiving a good amount of attention, and this is more focused on the accuracy assessment of DSMs. Finally, this is one of the last results that we have obtained. And this is an important outcome because this was supposed to be one of the first deliverable of our cost action at the end of the second year. We obtained the result to publish this almost a week ago. With a group of participants that have been involved relatively large. This paper is also receiving a good level of attention from the community. We obtained about 600 views in only a week. That is a good result for now. This means that the topic is of interest, but also I have to say that the manuscript is very dense of contents and information. The papers contains a number of consideration about the complexity of the problem in US survey application. And this graph that was made by Maria Polinova is extremely nice in identifying all the number of relationships that exist in all different elements that we should take into consideration when we use our UAS for any kind of application, for any kind of survey. And this is one of the reasons why we need the guidelines and support and clear indication when we perform our surveys. For this reason, we developed some guidelines that are more or less suggestions and advices about what should be done and what should not be done. Using mainly our experience, but also an extensive literature review. And this literature review has been divided in five stages that are the five stages requested in each US-based application. This stage include the flight mission, the study design, the pre-flight fieldwork, the processing of aerial data, and the quality assurance. Now, in each of each of these stages is discussed in the manuscript, providing all the information about the literature, providing suggesting about the different platforms to use, the advantages and disadvantages related to each of those. Eventually, we also provide some description of the sensors available and the opportunity offered by different sensors. Not only this, we also try to identify some guidance and practical guidance in the flying of the drones, providing a checklist of activities that we should follow in order to improve the quality and reduce errors during our flights. We also suggest that in order to enhance and improve our quality assurance, the use of metadata that should be compiled during our and after our flights, because in most of the cases we do not provide, we do not have information associated to the US observations regarding the camera setting, regarding characteristics of the sensor, flight plan, altitude. All this kind of information should be attached and linked to the data, to the US data, in order to allow the replication of experiments, in order to allow the comparability of the data, and in order to allow some advances in the field and to improve the overall quality of our surveys. In the manuscript, we also provide an overview of the tools available. This is just an example of the tools available for the fly mission. And in conclusion, we drafted a potential workflow of that we can use to build our US mapping. US-based mapping. This workflow includes a number of steps that somehow identify all the required steps for an ideal US mapping. Of course, each of these steps can be exploded and can and is has been associated to a specific reference that we have identified as a key reference in the literature for that specific step. So in the reality, with this workflow, we tried to reconcile all the available information in the literature that may allow us to improve it, to reach the best quality we could right now, given the current knowledge. So this is just a quick and very short overview of the contents of this last manuscript, and the entire manuscript can be downloaded for is freely available online. And closing this short presentation, I can say that with this manuscript represent the first pillar within the scope of the harmonious cost action to build a guideline in the use of UAS. This first pillar can be used as a reference for further application and in order to build next activities that are devoted to identify guidelines specialized in specific aspects that are linked to the topics and the features in which we are interested, that are more specifically, as you all know, related to the soil moisture monitoring, related to the vegetation mapping, related to the river monitoring as well. So all our working groups are somehow building and focusing right now on these new steps of the activities. And we can certainly support these activities, try to identify additional tools to support the identification of guidelines and tools that can improve data quality for US application. I close with this last slide that collects all the list of publications that have been produced by the Cost Action Harmonious. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Salvatore. If someone of you have comments, questions.
Yes, thank you very much for this presentation. I want to ask, you mentioned it, that we're talking now about reaching best quality. We already started doing the first paper when we talked about all approaches and techniques that we should apply to get the best quality. Even a way relating to specific tasks for soil moisture or agriculture, maybe we should to talk about sufficient quality. I mean that depends on the, your task classification or estimation spectral detail properties, the workflow can be reduced or spread, it depends on the task. Maybe we should put attention on it. To say, okay, if you're working on object counting, for example, count tomatoes in your field, you're not so, you shouldn't go so deeper in radiometric approaches, for example. This is enough to process the raw data. And in soil moisture task, it's opposite. We also depends on the area. If we're working on flat area, the effort that we're pushing on georeferencing should be less, and more efforts should be put on radiometric. And for example, in erosion monitoring, it's opposite situation also. What do you think? Is it interesting topic?
Sufficient quality.
It's talk about
the perspective, I think. The what we tried to do was to provide a comprehensive overview of what is available in the literature in terms of tools and in terms of knowledge. Of course, the question is, in most of the cases that we realized that the knowledge is very fragmented. And there is a number of scientists that is deepening a lot a specific topic and is neglecting, clearly neglecting some elements that may be critical. And they realize after trial error that they made this mistake. For instance, one is the georeferencing. Georeferencing is true, maybe less relevant in some contexts. You say, soil moisture, why should I care about georeferencing? And I can tell you, this is not totally true, because when you deal with any kind of monitoring, you like to perform monitoring over time and try to identify what is happening over time. And when you do multi-temporal analysis, georeferencing is extremely critical. Now, it's true that you don't need to have such a complex workflow in all the cases. And the workflow can be simplified, and in some cases, some elements can be removed. And this is certainly what each working group will try to do. For instance, I can make you an example with river monitoring. In river monitoring, all the radiometric correction is really, if we talk about image velocimetry, the radiometric correction is irrelevant. What is critical becomes in image velocimetry the geometric correction of the image, the stabilization of the image is also another issue that is very critical, and the contrast of the image. So the ability to identify features that can be recognized and traced within the image. So it is true, each specific feature or each specific variable requires a characterization that can simplify a general workflow. And some elements can be neglected sometimes. So it is true that we will never have the optimal, the best quality of our data, but the important is to be aware of what is the final quality we are talking about. So to be to have tools that allow us to identify the final quality we may obtain from the data set that we share. And for this reason, I think that a critical element was exactly the metadata that has to be introduced to the US data. Because when we look at our publication in the literature, in most of the cases, we have no idea about what camera has been used, what is the camera model, what is the drone that the people applied. Sometimes you have a lot of information about the camera, but you miss all the rest. For instance, in many of the mapping, orthomosaicing that we have reviewed, you miss a critical information that is the front overlap used for the flat plane. It's something that you should provide, I think, as a mandatory information in your publication, is in an appendix somehow, somewhere. So this was the argument that we made and that we shared all together. So we can simplify those the workflow, and the workflow can be specialized in order to provide the guidance. We cannot aim to have the best workflow ever realized, but we can try to identify a potential path. I don't know if I answered properly your question.
Yeah, thank you very much. I think, I reformulated this sentence and it matches that you said. It's very interesting to highlight the most critical parameters that we mentioned in workflow for specific tasks that we are considering in our working groups. I think it will be interesting to put efforts on it.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Salvatore. Thank you, Maria. Salvatore, your mic.
Okay, No, Maria, this is great. This is certainly something we can try to do, because Working Group 1 can support and has the knowledge to support the activities of our other working groups to build the proper strategy for their activities. So when we started the project, this was the idea that now we can somehow drain our information to the other working group, but we have also to try to select the information that has to be drained to the other working group. So the process of identifying the specialize the working flow for different categories of variables is something that we should try to do. It can be very useful and instructive, and very, very valuable, I think.
Okay, if there are any questions or suggestions. No? I will stop the recording then.